I'm Roger Dooley. I've been writing and doing videos about AI podcast tools like Google's Notebook LM and Jellypod for a month or two now. I've done a tutorial on how to use Notebook LM to create a podcast. Check my channel if you haven't seen it. Now that Jellypod is officially launching, I'm creating this short how-to video. Before we start the tutorial, let me explain a little bit about Jellypod and why you might want to use it to create audio content and maybe even a podcast. Jellypod takes content that you provide and creates audio about that. You can create the script and edit it. Most significantly, you can choose from dozens of different voices, genders, ages, accents, even specify the number of speakers. One speaker will give you a monologue. Two or more will give you a conversation. Another key feature is that Jellypod actually creates podcast episodes. It's a podcast creation tool with features that Notebook LM currently lacks. So let's just get started. Let's say I want to create a podcast called Persuasive Roger, and my first piece of content is an article I wrote on my neuromarketing blog about Robert Cialdini's seventh principle of influence, unity. So I will go over to jellypod.ai. I have logged in, and the first thing you'll see is a prompt for a tutorial. I suggest you check that out. So I'm going to close that, though, and I will go to the podcasts. We have no existing podcasts, so we'll click Create New Podcast. And as you can see, this is an actual podcast creation tool. You can upload a title, a description, a cover image, and whatnot, so it would be ready to publish as a podcast. I will type in some stuff here. We'll put in a short title. And it requires a description, so I'm just going to put in something very short here. And I'm also going to add a host. Now, the default host here is a synthetic person called Eric Marquette, who's a seasoned media professional, background in communication, and so on. We could also choose to clone our own voice or someone else's voice with their permission. We could choose from a library of other voices, which have various genders, accents, ages, and so on. For instance, a middle-aged Australian male with a deep voice, an American female, younger, and so on. There are lots of things to choose from. And so there's probably something there that would match whatever you're trying to create. So we're just going to click Create now. Let's see if it lets us do that. Oop, we have to actually add Eric to that host. Okay, we'll click Create. And it is creating it. It's created. Okay, we've now got the Persuasive Roger podcast, and we want to create our very first episode. Now here, we can do all kinds of things. We can paste in a website URL. We can attach a file. We can paste text. We can do different things that will then be used as the basis for this. So I had already copied the link to my article about Robert Cialdini's seventh principle unity. So I'm going to paste that in here and click Add Source. And as you can see, it's processing that. Now I could do additional things here. I could add in other articles by other people. I could paste some text in. You can add multiple sources here if you're trying to create a richer article. Now, I'm just going to go ahead with a single source and click Create. Now, that took about 10 seconds or so, so not too long. And as you can see, what we've got here is it's created a title, it's created an episode outline, and so on. It looks like it's just added one chapter. In other words, it's created a single topic. I've tested this with more content, and it'll create multiple chapters if there's additional content. And it says each chapter will be 2 to 4 minutes long. So this is going to be a fairly short podcast. And of course, it's based just on one article. I could have put in many more articles. I could have put in articles describing each one of Bob Cialdini's principles or other content about persuasion and so on. But just to keep things simple, we will use just this one chapter and proceed. And it's going to now, if I click Generate Transcript, it's going to create a transcript based on that outline. Now, that was very fast. They warn you that it can take up to 5 minutes, but that took probably less than 10 seconds. And as you can see, the transcript now has only Eric Marquette, because we only have a single speaker going, and there's the ability to edit the transcript. Now, Eric starts off saying, all right, so let's dive into Unity. Maybe I don't like all right. I'm going to edit this. So I changed this to begin with, welcome back to Persuasive Roger. And I could add additional text there, describing the podcast or whatever, but and just showing that this transcript can be edited. So if there's something that isn't to your liking, something that doesn't make sense, because remember, AI is not always perfect. It will make errors, and the text that it writes may not be as conversational as you like, or there may be other features to it that you need to change. But you can edit the podcast, and what I'm going to do now is click Generate Audio. Okay, that took about a minute, I would say. It didn't time it precisely, but not very long. And so now we can click play. Let's see what it sounds like.
Welcome back to Persuasive Roger. So let's dive into Unity, the seventh principle of influence introduced by Robert Cialdini. If you've been following his work, you're probably familiar with his original six principles, which have been staples in behavioral economics for decades. Those are reciprocity, commitment, social proof, authority, liking,
okay.
And scarcity.
That gives you a little bit of a flavor of what it's like. You may or may not like Eric Marquette's voice, but it's kind of a neutral, semi-pleasing voice. Nothing wrong with that. There was it sounded like a glitch at the beginning there, where it sort of skipped over that welcome back. I'm not sure if that was a playback glitch. I'm assuming that's what it is. I'm going to try one more time here.
Welcome back to Persuasive Roger. So let's dive in.
There we go. That was just a little playback glitch at the beginning. So that's pretty much it for this simple tutorial. I'll also include here an example of a two-host recording where they actually discuss each other. And one of those hosts is a voice clone of me. So you can see if you like that as well. So let's dive a bit deeper into this emotion versus reason debate. We know from that recent study, older adults had a 22% recall rate when exposed to emotional ads. Quite a jump compared to just a 7% recall for rational ads.
Quite revealing, Roger. And it speaks volumes, doesn't it? It's almost like our brains are hardwired to latch on to emotion, far more than cold, hard facts.
So, what do you think? Is Jellypod AI the tool for you? I think it's very interesting. I think it still needs a little bit of work and polish, but it's actually quite good. And think of it maybe not just as a tool for creating a real podcast that you're going to distribute and people are going to listen to, although it's capable of doing that. But think about it for, say, creating summaries of content that are easily digestible, easy to listen to, particularly if you're dealing with things like scientific papers or a lot of dense text. Creating a conversation about it might be a good way to distribute that to people, say, in a sales force or something, where you may wonder whether they'll have the patience to really consume a lot of heavy-duty content. This makes it a little bit easier to consume. Anyway, let me know what you think in a comment, and be sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for joining me. Thank you.